hitting the command of turn off rather than hitting the command of disconnect. That way they sit idle until you're ready to connect again. I've got a couple, two, three nodes. And if you tell them to shut down, then of course they shut down. But is there not a command that says disconnect somewhere in there?
Turn the car off, get out, do something, come back, turn back on. on the market yet.
Yeah, well, you know, you've got a jet pack. That's just a battery pack, and there, you don't have to turn the jet pack off if it's tickle charging from the cigarette lighters, so that would keep the power on the node all the time. And they don't draw much power in idle, hardly anything at all. The only time they draw power is when you boot them up. That's when the 2 amps is necessary from the power source. So whatever you do, just as long as you're aware of it there. I just didn't think that was a good idea and was expressing why I thought so. Catch you later, WB6IAG clear. But I'll pause for your question or whatever it is.
My habit is I don't turn anything off. The radio, like the one I'm talking to you on, stays on, and if I have to turn it off, I turn it off the power supply. And I have other radios that go 24/7 because to me, I was told that, you know, turning them on and off wears out.
And then turn right.
Same thing with light bulbs. If things that need to go,
turn right.
Turning them on and off is not good for them.
Well, due to my area of working as an engineer, we found that generally, in most cases, turning it off and on, any equipment, it's harder on it than it run continuously. I don't think, other than rebooting, I've turned off my computers once in 3 years. They settle down to a nice even temperature, and the constant temperature is much better than the cold to hot.
And then turn right.
So it's not just the off-on switch, it's the electronic components.
Turn right.
As long as they're adequately cooled, there's no reason to quit cycling them off and on, because that's where the wear and tear on the components, not just the power supply, but other components. So that's my philosophy, and that's what I've found with playing with it over the years, okay?
Now, the question comes up, I mean, I turn my computer on and off 2 or 3 times a day because you figure you don't want to be tracked. The same thing is with your cell phone is, you know, you turn your cell phone on when you want to use it, then turn it off, otherwise people are tracking you everywhere you want to go. But, I mean, it's harder with the cell phone because you never know when somebody needs to get a hold of you.
Well, everybody has their personal preference. My cell phone stay on, my handy talkie stays on except for at night when I'm sleeping, and otherwise my repeater stays on 24/7. So like I say, it's personal preference. That's just what I found, that was less wear and tear and less component failure when it was left on continuously, as long as they have adequate cooling wherever they're located. And not overheating from sitting for a long period of time, then usually the equipment will last a lot longer. Catch you later, Vera. Go back to my breakfast. WB6IAG.
Breakfast? This is like lunchtime already. KE6RAX. Thank you. Have a good day, Ron.
Hey, before you go there, RAX, KG6LYI. Question for you.
I can only handle so many questions in my head.
I gotta clear my mouth, but go ahead. I'm listening.
Uh, ask for RAX instead of the question to RAX. Instead of using your phone, turning on and off, get yourself an iWatch, where you can have your own separate number to the iWatch. Anybody calls you, you can just answer them like Dick Tracy on your iWatch. Have your phone turned off.
Yeah, but I think those iWatches, they can track you, and it's got GPS and all sorts of stuff in it, too. So it's always sending out a signal to someplace.
Yeah, but there's really no storage on it like a phone, so, not a whole lot they can do. I don't care if somebody tracks me. I don't care if they know where I'm at. There's not a whole lot they can do. So anyway, I just let you know the iWatch is pretty cool. You can leave your phone at home, and somebody calls you, you just answer them like the old Dick Tracy days with your iWatch.
Turn left.
They're talking about putting a chip in your head. You won't even have to carry a phone. You just think and it dials for you, and you know, you don't even carry a phone. It just deep green in your head.
Keep right and then turn right.
Yeah, new technology. I love it. I always stay current with all this stuff. In fact, I was watching intently yesterday
turn
for the launch of Elon Musk, you know, the two astronauts now up to the space station, but unfortunately the weather got the better of it, but it was sure fun, especially seeing the glass cockpit of the new capsule there. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, that was sort of interesting. Yeah, they talk about a friend of mine that I another caregiver, he got one of these, his wife bought him a watch, and he left it in, but took it off to wash his hands, and then left and forgot it, and somebody picked it up and put it in their pocket and walked off. So he went to his iPad, punched it in, got a GPS reading of where his watch was, tracked it down, caught up to the guy, told him, "Oh, I want my watch back." And he said, "I have your watch." And he says, "Yes, you do." And he dialed the phone, and his watch started ringing in the guy's pocket. Call the police if you don't give it back to me right now. But that's like a $1,000 phone. KK6RM.
So that application is available for anybody with any Apple product. I can go on my computer or my phone or whatever, and I can tell it to locate my items, and it'll put points exactly where all my items are, my iPad, my iWatch, my iPhone, and my computer. So it all shows up at the pinpoint exactly where they're at. I've used that several times to find my phone that I've just located.
I go out, people wanting to give me notes, I put it on your iPad, and I pull out my little notebook out of my pocket and my pen and start writing stuff down, and they stare at me funny.
It was like a shoecase. I think it was two-thirds battery. It had the little cable attached to a headset, but a little hand portion, just like you have in your home phone. And that sucker was huge and bulky, but, you know, for those days, pretty amazing. The very first phone that came out.
I still have my Fuchs phone in storage. Cost me $1,600. Weighs about 5.5 pounds, and it looks like I carry it around in a suitcase.
Comment?
That guy's in their comment. Yeah, I think a call for a 1 minute call was like $1.60 a minute at that time when they first came out. It's not cheap. Comment, go ahead.
KM6OCN. I had a similar experience. I got a very expensive, brand new, I might add, Wi-Fi earbud for my cell phone. And it was actually the
reason it was so nice and expensive was that it was one of the first ones to come out that handled multiple phones. I had three phones I had to use, being including my wife's and my personal one. I also had two from work. When I was under a...
Turn right.
Thank you.
Audio, loud and clear. 100% quieting. KM60N. Going in that time, but yeah, stick with the other mic that you just, the first one you have. KM60CN clear.
Okay, by the name being, and I'm located in Burbank, and I'm back on the mic, so I can have a clear right now.
Yeah, definitely sounds better. Talk to you later, Andy. KM60CN will be QSY up to
445.600.
Go straight on.
right, and then exit right. Go straight on and then turn right.
Thank you.
Turn left. Turn right. go straight on.